I just don't understand why whoever animated this in like 2003 was like, I need to have his dick out.
I'll get them.
Why does...
Like, it's just an extra thing to animate. If you put some pants on, it would save everyone a lot of time.
No, I think the pants would be extra to animate. Because then they have to have the pants physics, versus for the dick, they just have to have a tiny bit of dick physics.
But he's wearing a shirt.
That's true.
Why did they not just make him wear pants then?
No,
or it could be a long shirt, you know?
No.
What if Crazy Frog wore the long kurti?
Oh my god, ass cheeks out!
Ass out.
Shut the fuck up.
Sheer fabric.
No, see, if he wore pants, it would be so much more effort.
Panties.
It would be so much more effort because they would have to fully render the dick inside the pants and
That's
then
true.
The pants
That's
on top
true.
Of it.
You're right about that. He'd need both pants physics and bulge physics, you know?
And like if it slipped.
Right.
I'd like to apologize for
existing. So I can connect it on my computer.
Right. Okay, hold on. Connect what?
Discord.
Ooh.
Yeah.
Oh, that's so smart.
So that it doesn't just come through my phone.
We have yoga.
My mom is threatening me.
Why?
She's like, go to bed.
I will wake you up at 5 a.m.
I was like, why would you do that?
Here.
Hello?
Can I turn off the oven?
Oh yeah, you can turn off the oven. That's probably a good idea.
Ooh, I'm slipping and sliding.
Did everybody leave? Hello? Oh, hi. There we go. I just switched to my laptop. Done weed? Or league? Yes, once. Neither of us liked it particularly much.
Yeah,
all the feds that are listening.
We each had edibles once, and we also streamed while we were high.
Oh, yeah.
It sucked. I was like, oh my god, we've been streaming for hours, and it had been 10 minutes.
I kept going to the bathroom and being like, oh my god, I've been in the bathroom for 45 minutes. Everybody must be wondering, like, am I okay? And it was, like, 20 seconds. I didn't like it at all.
Cal described it very well the next day, in that they said, it felt like everything that you were doing, everything you had just done, you just dreamt that you did it. Anyway, it was a bad high.
I'm about to get high again, though. But for medical reasons. I'm having oral surgery. You inceptioned yourself. I don't think they gave me hydrocodone. I think they gave me Tylenol 3 with codeine. I think that's it. Codeine? Yeah, I think so. Hi, Ink.
Stream.
We're just live on Twitch eating our pizza. getting ready to start Phoenix
Wright.
It's
dinner time. Oh. Hi, Ink.
Yeah, we're gamers.
Damn, we only have one viewer, and yet we have two people in this call right now who could be viewing.
Capcom.
I'm kidding. I'm sorry. There's two viewers. I take it back. I apologize.
It is like a podcast.
We do one of those, too. Oh. I listened to an old podcast, and there was a part in there that you were like, this is just for Harshi.
Oh.
It was,
I said something about...
No, wait, I remember exactly what it was. Because I said Schrodinger's cat, and you said Schrodinger's pussy poppin'. And then Cal was like, I know that Harshi does not listen to this podcast, but that was for Harshi.
Look, I mean this in the least creepy way possible. Anytime that I think about pussy, I think about Harshi.
The word pussy.
Yeah, the word pussy.
Mm-hmm. Not the item.
Well, yes, okay, I'm programmed in certain ways. Shall we continue the Turnabout Samurai?
Sure, but I don't want to talk.
Oh yeah. We've been playing Phoenix Wright and doing all the voice acting. Oh my god. Yo, we could stream Valorant at some point. I wouldn't want to tag it as Valorant, because I wouldn't want to get, like, gamers in our stream, but...
We could tag it as, like, Valorant, and then, like, casual and gay.
True.
We tag but all of our streams as gay.
People would still find it, you know,
yeah,
from the Valorant tag.
Yeah, but what if they were like, damn, y'all are okay and subbed? Mm.
The thing about Phoenix Wright is that you only get fanfic writers, really, which isn't as bad as gamers.
Thanks. I love to be not as bad as gamers.
Well, you're a gamer too, so.
I saw some spoilers, not about this game, but about Edgelord's backstory. What's his name?
Miles Edgeworth.
Edgeworth's backstory, and I was like, aw,
Miles Edgeworth, Esquire.
I don't even remember what the spoilers were. I just remember how they made me feel, which was, aw, and then Ink was right.
Welcome, Ink.
Welcome to the stream. You're so loud. Could you hold on?
Yeah, let me turn you down real quick.
You're so loud.
Yeah, it's because I have you at 200%. Actually, it's because I thought it was important to hear what you said. It was probably because your phone was bad.
Ink, welcome.
Should we load this?
Ink, Harshi and MK just found out about Mimi and Lena. Mimi and Lena.
My sisters. Interesting.
Hmm.
That's curious. Oh my god. Oh my god. What the fuck? Should we load the selected save data? Okay. Oh my god. Yeah. So that all of our viewers can see. Chung chung.
Is the audio not coming through?
Oh, you're right. I don't think I have it set to... It is set to monitor input.
Mm.
Is it not turned up? Oh, the voice chat audio is not on stream. Interesting.
Oh, that's funny.
Well, yeah, that is very funny. I see. Interesting. Okay. Let's try that. Does that work? No, that didn't do anything. Interesting.
See you, MK.
Bye, MK. Maybe I do need
the sound capture.
Yeah.
Wait, should there be background noise now?
Yeah, there should. There should certainly should be there, right?
Bye.
Bye.
Bye, friend. Mm.
Maybe I do need to download Elgato Sound Capture.
We could just play Valorant on stream.
No. I'm not gaming for real.
That's fair. Will do. Good night.
No, he's asleep. Can you get your computer and see if you have Elgato Sound Capture?
Yeah, I'll try and see.
Sure. Bye. Hello. Huh. Okay, that should work now. Yes, fixed.
This is a song that we should play.
What?
You know how he played Caramel Dancing? This is our song.
Yeah, that's right.
What if we danced this at our wedding?
Oh my god, we could. Congratulations.
Congrats.
Hang on, I got something stuck in my teeth. I'm gonna floss.
No worries. Oh my god. Oh my god. You almost brained me. You only took one hit? Oh, during the Cynthia battle. That's still impressive. Oh, we didn't post in stream Discord.
No, we didn't. That's okay. We don't have any audio. Did you figure that out?
Wait, you just said you got it.
No, I got the desktop audio working.
I'm so sorry.
I didn't get the Elgato working. Otherwise, we'd hear that. Triple air slash flinch is great. Sorry to anyone watching the VOD. Not our best one. Camera's a little bit behind. It doesn't show up.
Mm-hmm.
It's on here. Oh, I forgot I partitioned this. Whoops. And what do I do?
Open the application.
Okay. Okay.
Mm.
No capture
device. Do you not have, like, a... Where's mine? I'm just checking an app, like...
Oh, there we go. Game Capture HD.
Oh, Game Capture HD. Right, right, right. It's gonna fuck...
Oh, there we go. That's all I had to do.
Do you want me to mute that?
The TV?
What?
The TV.
Oh, sure, sure, sure. Let's change this to running switch. Let's see, can we just do the best quality? Sure. Okay. And now if I close this, will it keep going?
What do you think? I think so. Oh no.
Yeah, it did. We just have it turned down.
Nice.
Yeah.
I guess you have to just open it once to kickstart the connection.
Yeah. Okay. There we go. All right.
Gaming time.
I'm eating, so I can't voice.
All right. Should I do your Will Powers voice?
Sure. If you wanna.
Mr. Wright.
Yes?
Why do you look so unhappy?
Nothing. Really, it's nothing. Right, Mia. Right, Mia? Uh-oh, she looks even unhappier. Phoenix, your client is now practically a dead man walking. Perhaps that's why I feel particularly close to him.
Do you want to post in the Discord now that we have things running?
Mm-hmm.
This is not the time for dead people jokes, please.
You know we're going into this trial utterly defenseless. Yet, if Mr. Powers is truly innocent, we should be able to find something overlooked in the evidence to prove it.
Something overlooked?
We have to find something, Phoenix, today. It's that or lose the trial.
This isn't gonna be easy.
Why does she have even more titties now that she's dead?
Chung chung.
Court is now in session for the trial of Mr. Will Powers.
The prosecution is ready, Your Honor.
The defense is ready, Your Honor.
Very well. Mr. Edgeworth, your opening statement, please.
An unexpected fact has come to the attention of the court. Yesterday, we learned that there were other people present at the studios. Today, I would like to show evidence proving that they had nothing to do with the murder.
Very well. You may call your first witness, Mr. Edgeworth.
I wonder if it'll be the producer. The prosecution calls Mr. Salmonella to the stand. Or that director.
Man, Hershey would be so impressed right now. Oh, I forgot Salmonella's voice.
Will the witness state his name and profession?
It was like...
How rude can you get? You don't know me.
No,
I'm the director. I made the Steel Samurai noob, Raffle. Salmonella. I'm a director. Television.
Were you at the Global Studios on the day of the murder?
Yes, Your Honor.
Hmm. Very well. Please testify to the court about the events of that day.
Phoenix, let's start by picking this testimony apart. If Powers is innocent, you know what that means. Someone in the trailer on that day did it.
Right. She doesn't waste any time putting on the pressure.
I was at the studios from around 9 o'clock that morning. During the morning, I was doing, an action scene run-through. It took a lot more time than I thought it would. I hear that everyone ate lunch at the employee area. But I had a meeting in the Studio 2 trailer, so I ended up skipping lunch. We were in the meeting until around 4. During the meeting, well, I'm pretty sure no one left their chairs. That's about it.
Can we review our evidence?
Yeah.
The time of Mr. Hammer's death was 2:30 p.m. And according to your testimony, you were in the meeting at that time. Mr. Wright, you may begin your cross-examination.
Did MK leave just voice chat, or is he watching the stream?
I can check.
Yes, Your Honor.
All right. Oh, why would he go to sleep?
Remember, his sleep schedule's been fucked up. He's been waking up at like 6 p.m.
In the studios from around 9 that morning. Okay, I don't see why we'd... I already pressed it.
Is that when you always come into work?
Oh no. I come in at all sorts of hours. It's the industry way.
Yeah, I know all about the freaks in your industry.
Oh my god. Phoenix knew about Harvey Weinstein.
Holy shit.
Still, for what it's worth, I was pretty busy that day, open parenthesis.
Tell us more about that.
Might as well.
In the employee area.
That's right. It was a fight scene between the Steel Samurai and the Evil Magistrate.
Was anyone else at the run-through?
Oh, yeah. That security lady was sitting there watching the whole time. She was cheering on Hammer, if you can believe it.
She certainly has the lungs for it. Anyone else?
Nope, just us four.
Why did it take more time?
Why did it go on so long?
I'm pretty sure you've already heard about this. But WP twisted his ankle during the run-through, see?
Oh, right. Thus the limp.
Which, of course, led me to missing my lunch, ROFS.
What does ROFS stand for?
ROFS? Rolling on the floor, starving?
Did they?
What exactly did they have for lunch?
T-bone steak! The assistant cooked some up!
Come to think of it, there was a plate with some bones on it in the employee area. Everyone else, meaning that the witness did not eat with them.
But I had a meeting in the Studio 2 trailer, so I ended up skipping lunch.
So, in the end, you didn't get to eat?
Yeah, no steak at least. Can you believe it?
That must have been tough.
Phoenix.
Yeah?
Doesn't something about that seem odd to you?
It's contradictory.
Sure.
I don't know. I don't think so.
It's a little vague. What do you think?
I feel like if she's pointing it out, it's contradictory, you know?
Sure.
Yeah, it does seem odd now that you mention it. Mr. Manella.
What do you want?
When I went to Studio 2, I saw something on the table there. There were two plates, the same kind of plates as the ones in the employee area. Who ate lunch there?
Good call, asterisk sweats, asterisk. I was embarrassed, so I didn't mention it. But I did eat after all.
A T-bone steak, you mean?
Yeah, well, I mean, the assistant went through all that trouble. I brought it to the trailer, thinking I could eat it later.
Clearly a man who likes to eat. I'd suspected as much. So, when exactly did you eat it?
We took one break during that meeting. I wolfed it down then. Asterisk, drool, asterisk.
A mental image I will carry with me to my grave. Wait a second. If they took a break in that meeting, that contradicts his testimony. I'll press on that one a bit more.
Next one?
Oops.
Press.
You didn't take a single break?
Well... Yeah, not a one, asterisk sweats, asterisk.
What's he sweating so much about, I wonder? If only I had an idea. Wait a second. Maybe I do have an idea.
Press harder.
Wait a second. Mr. Manella, you've just contradicted yourself. Didn't you just tell the court that you ate a T-bone steak during a break?
Oops, raffle.
Well?
Mr. Manella, what's all this about?
Well, yeah, I guess I did take a little break.
Phoenix, great job. If they took a break, one of them could have gone to the studio during that time.
Your Honor, I call on the witness to testify to the court about this break.
Very well. Mr. Manella, your testimony, please.
Urgh.
Uh-oh. Edgeworth is laughing.
Maybe he's just laughing because people use him for this.
Yeah. For FWIW, we took a break. A raffle. But it was only 15 minutes. 15! That's only 13 in base 12. Not enough time for someone to, say, commit murder in Studio 1.
Wait,
lol.
That... 13 in base 12? 13 in base 12 is, isn't that 144 plus 36?
What?
Oh, no, sorry, the ones unit is always the same.
Yeah. Oh, it's...
Never mind, yeah, 13 base 12. Sorry, anyway,
it's 12 plus 3.
Yeah.
What? It's definitely not 11 in base 12. It's 12 plus 3.
Ink.
That's only enough time to eat a T-bone steak, if you ask me.
The brain cell that we share, Cal was holding it that time.
I don't think it would even be enough time for that, but that's just me. Very well. You may begin the cross-examination.
Yeah, for what it's worth, we took a break, Raffle.
Okay, I don't think we need to press on that.
But it was only 15 minutes. 15!
Well, we should probably press on that since we did have a discussion about it.
What were you doing for those 15 minutes?
Eating my T-bone steak. What else?
There were two plates on that table.
Oh, right. The other one was Diva's. Sorry, Dee Vasquez's plate.
Dee Vasquez, the producer.
Oh, yeah. Oh.
To eat a T-bone steak in 15 minutes. That's quite a feat. Why is that?
Thank you, Joey, for following.
Thank you for the follow, Joey.
I don't know why our widgets don't work. They just blink and disappear.
I have to say, you look like a guy who gets through his meals pretty fast.
Well, I was facing a cold, slightly chewy T-bone steak. Even I have to take my time with eating that kind of food. Lol.
Well, Phoenix?
Okay, I can take on a voice if you
want. That testimony was too short to be... to wring any kind of useful information out of. All you have to do is prove that he was able to get to Studio One in that time. Oh, great. Is that all?
Either way, we're happier here, Joey. This is Nancy Drew, except gay.
Yeah. Okay, oh, we already pressed on him.
It's not actually Nancy Drew. It's... What if Nancy Drew was a lawyer instead of a detective?
Yeah, what if the game, the main gameplay of Nancy Drew took place outside of the...
This is fair. This is fair. We apologize.
Okay, hang on. Well, let's press on this.
What time exactly did you take this break?
I'd say it was from around 2:30 or so to 2:45.
2:30? That's the time of death. So we could have gone to Studio One, killed Hammer, and come back. I guess it's possible, time-wise.
Wow.
Edgeworth, dot.
I'll be honest, I've been reading a lot of Kyoya Kaoru fanfiction from Ouran High School Host Club, and these two are just giving me adjacent feelings. Ink, I read a really good one. I'll send it to you and also read Potion Wine.
Objection. Oh, we didn't trigger Edgeworth's objection for whatever reason the first time that we pressed on that.
Haven't we had enough of this pointless line of questioning? Your Honor, the testimony to this point...
Oh my god, Joey started playing Ace Attorney.
Oh my god.
I will.
The testimony to this point has made one certain fact painfully clear. The people in the trailer had nothing to do with this murder. It was impossible for any of them to get to Studio One.
What?
Something wrong, Mr. Wright? Surely you aren't suggesting that one of the people in the trailer went to Studio One?
Well, Mr. Wright?
Phoenix, this is critical. Think about it before you give your answer.
Do you claim someone from the trailer went to Studio One?
Okay, here's the thing. Hi! Here's the thing. I don't think it's possible because they said the break started at 2:30, and that was the time of death.
Well, but he might have lied.
Yeah. I never, whenever I underestimate this game, it proves me wrong, and whenever I overestimate this game, it also proves me wrong.
I mean, it's either D. Vasquez or the, Penny, right?
Pairs
of glow-in-the-dark pantyhose?
I don't know why I said lederhosen. No, with the information given, it's impossible.
Well, but where do we go from? Where does the game go from us saying that it's impossible?
Penny. And then I can have someone to voice.
That's true. But, like, we just went on, like, implying that somebody went. Okay, I'll
that's
say
true,
no,
that's
it's impossible.
True. Oh.
I don't want to write off so many possible suspects, but I can't keep claiming the impossible either. I agree that it was impossible for anyone in the trailer to go to the studio at that time.
Ha ha!
Ha ha!
I thought you might be thoughtlessly treading on thin ice again, but I see you had at least an inkling of the truth.
What do you mean, Mr. Edgeworth?
It's quite simple. True, the break-in in the trailer meeting came right at the time of death. However, the path from there to the scene of the crime was blocked. The fallen Mr. Monkeyhead barred the way.
Excuse me, it's Mrs.
At around 2:15, a strong gust of wind knocked off the studio mascot's head.
This is why it's pregnant.
Ergo, when the people in the trailer took a break at 2:30, the way to the studio was blocked. Blocked by Mr. Monkey's severed head. It's actually Mr. Monkey, but Edgeworth has a point. And somehow I feel no desire to correct him. I believe we have seen enough evidence. I would like to relieve Mr. Manella from the stand.
What
It's over.
Very well. The court's opinion on this case is as follows. We have found that there were several other people in Studio 2 on the day of the murder. However, it is also clear that none of those people could have gone to Studio 1. They therefore have no relation to this case. Furthermore, with regards to the photo of the Steel Samurai, given that the size of the costume, no one other than Mr. Powers could have worn it that day. All that is lacking is decisive evidence that he is the one who did it. If we had that, I'm afraid we would have to find Mr. Powers guilty.
Don't do it!
Your Honor, the prosecution is pleased to announce that we indeed have decisive evidence.
Penny?
The witness.
Here we go. Now is our murderer.
Who is this witness, Mr. Edgeworth?
My witness saw the very moment when the Steel Samurai skewered
the
victim.
Who do you think it is?
Is it the kid?
I think it's Penny.
Order! I will have order!
The kid is
yeah,
a good
guess. Yeah, it's probably Penny because she's probably... This is probably the part where they call the murderers to stand, mm-hmm. You know?
I see. The court will take a 10-minute recess, after which we will hear your witnesses. Court is adjourned for recess.
Oh, I love recess.
Chung chung. What do we do now, Mia?
They're just two perfect spheres, almost.
If everyone in that trailer has an alibi. I'm sorry, Phoenix. I guess I was wrong. Mia! Don't tell me you're giving up.
I can do a voice
if you give up, what hope do I have? I like doing Mia. Don't get me wrong. I've never given up on a trial before. Not while there was still a chance. Only one thing became clear in your cross-examination. The people in the trailer could not have gone to Studio One. I thought there was more to it than that. But I was wrong. That's all there is. Oh wait, this is you.
Oh my god. Oh, I have the hiccup, so I don't know if I can do this.
What's gonna happen to me? It kinda seems like everyone in that courtroom thinks I did it. They think I'm a murderer.
Don't worry, Mr. Powers.
Wait, did he have an accent too?
I don't think so. Okay. You just did your...
My very lowest voice.
If you are innocent, we will prove it. I guarantee. Leave it to us, and be yourself. Be strong. You were the Steel Samurai, hero to children everywhere, after all.
I... You... Thanks.
Okay, Phoenix. This one's for the kids. Let's do it.
It's literally cut like this. Like, mm-hmm. This. Who do you think that... Oh, yeah. Darn.
Court is back in session for the trial of Mr. Will Powers.
The prosecution has a concern.
Oh?
As our witness is a grade schooler of tender years,
damn.
And this is a murder case, we worry that the defendant might cause unnecessary trauma with his cruel questioning. Nice to see Edgeworth is taking the moral high ground. However, we have no choice. The prosecution calls Cody Hackins to the stand.
I love him.
Your Honor, perhaps you could arrange a box for him to stand on.
Oh, right. Guard, please bring him a box. One of those donut crates should do.
Will the witness state his name and grade in school?
Was this you or me?
I feel like it was... Well, let's both give a try at the line.
Okay.
Like an audition.
Yeah.
Witness!
You can go first.
No, you go first. I think it was me, but I don't remember my voice.
What? Just because you're all grown up doesn't mean you can push me around.
What? Just because you're all grown up doesn't mean you can push me around.
That's you.
That's it.
Cody? Answer his question, okay?
Hey, it's you, the nice lady. I'm Cody Hackens. I'm in second grade.
I get the feeling this is going to be a long, long day.
Mr. Edgeworth, please remember that you're speaking to a child. Try to be gentle.
Ugh. Witness, Cody. He's having trouble with this gentle thing. You were present, you were at Global Studios on the day of the, incident.
You got a problem with that?
Please tell us what you saw that day.
It sounds like yours, that one guy voice. Cha-ha-ha.
My scum tank?
Yeah.
What, Pops? And you want me to tell you and Gramps with that beard over there?
Just, Mr. Edgeworth would be a very long day.
Incidentally, photographic equipment is strictly prohibited in this courtroom.
My apologies, Your Honor. He said he wouldn't testify if he couldn't bring it. I'd like special permission, if that's possible. Wait, so you're saying you had a bargain terms with a kid,
and you lost? Damn.
Hey, I just got this new camera.
Damn, he a prosecutor, and he got beat?
Don't really know how to use it all that good yet. But I bring it with me everywhere I go.
Phoenix, I wonder if he had that camera on the day of the murder. You'd better make a note of that in the court record.
Very well, Cody. Please testify to the court about what you saw on the day of the incident.
I wanted to see the Steel Samurai rehearsal just once. I found a map on the internet, and I went to the studios on that day. I went through the woods off the path so that that old lady wouldn't catch me. I was going to the studio. I got kind of lost on the way, though, for about 30 minutes. When I came out by the studio, there was the Steel Samurai. It totally rocked. Right before my eyes, out came the bad guy. Of course, the Steel Samurai took him down. Pow! If I had my camera with me, it would have been the time for a shot, I tell ya. Anyway, I couldn't get in the studio, so I went home.
Very well. The defense may begin its cross-examination. But be gentle. Remember, you're talking to a child.
This kid is tougher than most adults we see in here, honestly.
Okay. He seemed like he'd been there before, though.
You really like the Steel Samurai, huh?
Of course I do! I've taped every show, and I go to all the live performances.
That's impressive. Have you been to the amusement park?
Of course! Duh! My dad always takes me.
Poor, poor dad. Was that day the first time you'd been to the studio?
Actually, I've been a couple times. I never managed to get there on rehearsal day. And that security lady's always yelling.
Right, right. Please continue.
Chill, Pops. I'm getting to it. How am I supposed to talk with you cutting me off all the time? Jeez!
Ah. Off the path.
Yeah, you know how the studios are in a valley there. If you go off the path a little bit, there's the woods. That's where I was. I see.
I see.
Anyhow.
Did nothing unusual happen on your way to the studio?
Unusual?
Did you see this monkey here by any chance?
Oh, you mean Mr. Monkey? Yeah, I saw him, but his head wasn't busted.
So you went straight to the studio? You got lost in the woods.
Yeah, I couldn't figure out which way I was walking. Man, I was relieved when I saw the blue studio doors. But guess what happens next?
The Steel Samurai.
Yeah, he was standing by the studio gate. It looked like he was thinking about something before going in. Then he opened up the gate and went inside.
I see. What then? What sort of bad guy was it?
A guy? A person? Kinda tall. Skinny.
Are you sure it was a guy?
I don't know. He was kinda far away.
Huh. He's being awfully vague. What happened to the bad guy?
Huh? Well, he kinda didn't move. Not a bit. Like he was dead. I guess he's a real pro. What a great actor.
Yes, I suppose he was. Hold it. If you had your camera? You mean you weren't carrying your camera then?
No, I wasn't. It's not like I have it all the time.
Should we try and present it?
Really?
Because this is Cody's always carrying it.
I guess seeing the killing freaked him out and he went home. Phoenix, remember, he's a child. Use gentle words. But be firm. Easy for you to say. Cody, what you just said seems, well, a little strange. Didn't you say before that you always bring your digital camera wherever you go?
I like how it looks like we're in the jury.
You were quite clear about that.
Huh?
Cody, you shouldn't lie here. You understand that, right?
Mr. Wright, a word with you.
Uh-oh. Was I putting the pressure on too much?
What is this digital camera contraption you're talking about?
It's, a digital camera, Your Honor. It's kind of a new sort of camera. How do I explain that?
I see.
Anyway, Cody, I can't believe you wouldn't bring your camera on a trip to the studios. You did bring it, didn't you? Mr. Wright. How cruel you are to terrorize a poor child so. I don't care if he's a child or a prosecuting attorney. No one should lie in court.
What do you mean, or a prosecuting attorney?
What? Yeah, so I had my camera. So what? You got a problem with that?
Oh, I'm standing on a little donut crate.
So, you did have a camera. And did you use this camera?
Why would I use it? I was too busy watching.
Very well. Please testify to the court about what you were so busy watching.
Hang on.
Yeah?
I'm gonna refill my beverage. Actually, I'm just gonna drink the rest of that thing.
Good night.
Are you sleepy?
I know. I didn't drink through it. But if I drink through it these days, I've drunk too much.
I see. What? Oh, this is yours.
Yeah, I just wanted a hug.
I made a commitment at the beginning of the evening.
That's true.
My commitment was...
I won't.
I drank my gin and coffee
which means that I have to get drunk enough that I feel sleepy.
Otherwise, I'm gonna be up all night. Yeah, I had my camera with me.
I can take a shot.
But I was glued to the action. I couldn't take my eyes off of it. The Steel Samurai, he goes for the bad guy. Wham! Then the bad guy stopped moving. He's so strong. The Steel Samurai rules.
I think my voice leveled up. Or maybe my... Oh, I have my headphones in the opposite sides. That's why it sounds different.
Hmm. Ah, is that all? Well, that was brief. Mr. Wright, your cross-examination.
Okay. Yes, he had his camera with him.
So you were watching the Steel Samurai. Did you watch the whole fight?
Yeah, of course.
You didn't turn away, not even once?
No.
Okay, then tell us exactly what happened.
Yeah, I'm getting to that.
So the bad guy attacked him first?
Yeah.
What sort of person was this bad guy?
I told you, a person. He was a person.
How was he dressed?
I kind of don't remember. I was too busy watching the Steel Samurai.
I see. And what happened next?
Oh, I maybe shouldn't have pressed on this.
Why?
Huh? What do you mean, why?
Why wasn't the bad guy moving?
Well, because the Steel Samurai brought him to justice.
And how exactly did he do that?
How did he do it? With a samurai kick, and a samurai punch, samurai chop, samurai slap, something like that.
He's still being vague about this.
Wait, don't give me that look, Pops.
How should I play this?
Let's wait and see what happens, I think, right? Or should we press harder? I think the game is telling us not to press a kid.
Yeah, know? Don't press a kid.
Yeah, if I press too hard now, the judge might keep me from continuing. I'll sit back and see how the rest of this goes. What did you do after the bad guy fell, Cody?
Actually, the fight was so intense that I got kind of scared. So, I went straight home.
Something isn't adding up here. Something about his account doesn't seem right. Phoenix. It doesn't seem right because he's being deliberately vague. Press him on the facts, Phoenix. Find out what he saw. So, why didn't you use it? He's getting to that. Relax and listen.
I didn't use it because I was too busy watching the real thing.
So you were watching the Steel Samurai.
Probably already went through this. I guess we gotta press further on this. We're gonna press him harder, huh?
Cody!
What?
Something's bothering me. Before you said that you couldn't take your eyes off the action.
Yeah? So what?
Yet you missed the most important part. What is the...
Whoops.
What is the meaning of this? You know as well as I do that he's being vague. Tell me, what kind of a murderer uses a samurai slap?
Ugh.
Hang on, that's not a Miles Edgeworth noise.
Oof. My point is this. Cody, you may have seen some of the Steel Samurai's fight, but you missed the most important part, the killing blow.
Sure.
Order! Order! Mr. Wright, how could this be? Can you explain how he might have missed something so vital?
That's the thing. Phoenix, I believe you're on the right track with this. Think, why didn't Cody see the climax of the fight? I know you. You can figure this out.
Mr. Wright, your answer.
Why do you think he didn't see the climax of the fight? Do you think he ran away?
We have ascertained that this young boy is a great fan of the Steel Samurai. Why wouldn't he watch the climax of the fight?
Oh, what's our evidence that we could show?
Oh, he would have taken a picture of the samurai winning from the scrapbook.
Huh. Here's the options. He couldn't watch it, which seems likely. He was watching something else or show evidence. Should we show the scrapbook? Is that what you're thinking?
Maybe. Because, like, he was like, oh, the samurai won, and it was awesome because he always wins. But I didn't take a picture of it because reasons.
Right.
And, like, the scrapbook proves that he usually takes a picture of every time.
But that doesn't really answer the question, because the question is, why wouldn't he watch the climax of the fight?
That's true. Yeah, go with the other thing.
Unless he was trying to figure out how to learn, like, unless he was trying to learn how to use his camera. Let's say he couldn't watch it.
Yeah.
Because he couldn't watch it. How could he calmly watch a murder taking place at his age? Just a moment, please. One thing has become quite clear in this boy's testimony. He did not believe he was witnessing a murder. He was watching the Steel Samurai fight, like on TV. The more real the fight, the more he could have watched.
I have to agree with Mr. Edgeworth.
You need me to open this?
Yeah, I'm weak.
Did you? No, you just didn't do it.
Oh, you have to peel that thing. Yeah. I forgot. I'm sorry. Thank you.
Well, Mr. Wright, do you have another explanation? We have ascertained that this young boy is a great fan of the Steel Samurai. Why wouldn't he watch the climax of the fight?
Your Honor, I have evidence.
Evidence?
Yes, Your Honor.
Why did Cody look away from the fight?
I think it's because he was trying to figure out how to use the camera.
Sure. That makes sense.
Or because he was looking at his scrapbook. What do you think? Joey says the scrapbook. They think you're right about the scrapbook. Let's go
with the scrapbook.
Two votes.
Take that. Here's my proof.
Proof?
Can I do that again? This doesn't prove anything.
Oh no.
Ha! Lost your nerve, have you? Very well, I'll ask you the question again. We have ascertained that the young boy is a great fan of the Steel Samurai. Why wouldn't he watch the climax of the fight?
Alright, now maybe show the camera?
Yeah.
That's probably right. Sorry about that.
That's okay.
Here's my proof.
The music stopped.
What's that? The camera?
The witness stated that he recently received the camera.
Yes, I'm aware of that.
He wasn't entirely familiar with this operation. Big brain.
You become a lawyer who also has to be a detective.
I'm aware of that too.
Correct. Why would Cody be looking at something else? at the critical moment because he was looking at his camera. He was trying to take a picture.
Hey!
Bullseye.
What's your problem, Pops? You gotta think picking on little kids.
Pressing, not picking. Good job, Phoenix. Cody was lying, clearly. Smart of you to realize that there was no way he could just stand there, watching his hero, and not take a picture. Right. Cody? There was only one reason why you would have looked away from the fight. And that was because you wanted to take a picture. But having just received your camera, you weren't used to using it yet. So you missed the climax of the fight, correct?
Yeah.
Well, Phoenix, I'll bet you anything he's hiding more than that. Have him testify again. Right. Mia means business. Your Honor, the defense would like to request that Cody Atkins testify once more.
Very well. Cody, could you please tell us about your camera? And about why you didn't take a picture of the fight?
Welcome to the real world, kid.
Can you do Cody?
Yes. Yeah, you're right, Pops. The Steel Samurai had just escaped from the clutches of the villain. So I held up my camera to take a picture. But the lens wouldn't open in time, so I missed it. So that's all that happened. Yup.
Anything strange in that testimony, Mr. Wright?
I'm not sure. But I'd like to proceed with the cross-examination anyway.
No photo? Yeah, right, Pops. It's just Samurai, just to see from the clutches of the villain.
So you did see the beginning of the fight?
Yeah.
Did you notice anything unusual?
I guess Steel Samurai was moving a little strange.
Moving strangely?
So I held up my camera to take a picture.
Why couldn't you just take a picture?
My new camera has too many buttons. I couldn't figure it out. I tried to take a picture. I really tried. But the lens wouldn't open in time, so I missed it.
When the lens opened, what did you see?
A person on the ground and the Steel Samurai. That's all that happened. Yep.
That's all?
Yeah, I told you, I didn't take a picture.
I would have, once I got that lens open. Did he really not take a picture? Not even one?
Press up hard.
Nah, he definitely would have taken a picture. There's gotta be something there I can use. Cody. Listen up, Cody Atkins. I know exactly what happened that day. You took a picture.
Hey!
Bullseye?
How did you know?
I see through all your lies, Cody Atkins. It's one of my powers.
Wow.
This feels great.
Phoenix.
Yeah, I took a picture.
Perhaps you can change your testimony to reflect this, Cody.
I took a few shots, but it was too late, so I erased them.
You erased them?
Yeah!
Why would you erase a picture of your beloved Steel Samurai, victorious?
Well, you know. Why would I want to keep a picture like that?
He's becoming less and less cooperative. I better find a clear contradiction soon, or some solid evidence. How can I pick holes in such a short testimony? There has to be something. Dig up the dirt, Phoenix. Find out what this kid's all about.
You could show him the scrapbook. Maybe not on this line, but on one of the lines.
Well, let's press him on this. Pops.
Yeah, Yeah, I called you Pops, you spiky-haired geezer.
Geezer?
I'm Mr. Edgeworth, and I'm the bearded gentleman.
That's what I hate about grown-ups. You're all so self-conscious.
Okay, off with the kid's gloves. Testify, witness, testify.
Sorry, you just said off with the kid's gloves.
Steel Samurai just went, so I held my ground, but the villains won't open in time. The Jeremy shows when it was too late. So, I erased him.
Yeah, let's present this track button. Oh, music stopped. Cody!
What? What? Man, every time you say Cody, you follow it with something bad.
I just wanted to thank you for giving me this the other day.
Huh? Oh, right.
What was it you told me then?
I go to every live performance. I always take a picture when the Steel Samurai lands the final blow with Sam. I got them all. I never missed one. A perfect collection.
Cody, did you really get a picture of the Steel Samurai standing victorious over his foe? If you did, I find it hard to believe that you would just erase it.
Wait, can I do my hypothesis?
Sure.
I think that whoever was in the Steel Samurai outfit was actually in the other outfit, and then they traded outfits.
Ah.
Wouldn't you keep it for your album?
Ah!
Mr. Wright, what exactly is this album?
It's called Path to Glory.
It's looks a like it's called
pictures
Samurai
of the Steel Samurai, all taken by Cody Hackens. He claims it's a perfect collection of every battle that the Steel Samurai has won.
I see.
Don't you find this very odd, Your Honor? Among all his pictures of the Steel Samurai, none were taken that day.
Order.
I'll be right back.
Mr. Wright, have you an explanation? If the Steel Samurai had just defeated his adversary, I certainly would expect to see a picture of it in this album.
Exactly my point, Your Honor. No, wait, no way. Phoenix, I think we finally discovered the truth. And what a truth it is. Mia, are we sure about this? Did he actually... Yes, I'm pretty sure what you're thinking is right. Tell them, Phoenix. Tell them what the truth is.
Mr. Wright, please explain to the court what is going on here. Why was there no picture in the album from the day of the murder? Why would the boy have erased the photos he took?
Because they were of his dad.
The Steel Samurai didn't win. I think you were right.
I can think of only one reason, Your Honor. The Steel Samurai didn't win. That's why Cody deleted those photos.
You mean the Steel Samurai lost?
Well, Cody, I'm right, aren't I? Tell the truth. The bad guy defeated the Steel Samurai.
No way! No! It's impossible. The Steel Samurai never loses. He never loses anyone. Ever.
Your Honor, the witness has revealed everything with his words. There was a reason why he lied and told us he didn't take a picture. The same reason he erased his precious photos. For Cody, it was inconceivable that the Steel Samurai could be defeated. However, Cody witnessed the impossible. He saw the Steel Samurai lose. Yet to admit that what he saw would destroy everything he believed in.
Oh, Cody.
That's why he lied and said the Steel Samurai won. He couldn't handle the truth.
Oh my god. Order!
Order! I will have order! Witness, I mean, Cody, is this true? What did you see? Tell the court what you saw.
I...
Do you like my breath control?
Yeah.
Thank you.
Cody. That day, You saw the Steel Samurai lose a fight, right?
Wow! Okay, okay. You're right. The Steel Samurai fell down. Then he didn't move.
Bless you.
Order! Order! Order!
What kind of stunt are you trying to pull, right? The Steel Samurai was the murderer, not the victim.
That explained this.
Yet according to your witness's testimony, the Steel Samurai was the one who fell.
Mr. Wright, what's going on?
Apparently, we have all made a serious error.
An error?
What's all this about? Okay, both of these are true, right?
So maybe that means the third one is true as well.
I don't think so. They can't have both of them be the victim and then nobody be the victim. If you understand what really happens, it's actually quite simple. At the end of the fight, the Steel Samurai fell to the ground and lay still. In other words, that explains why the costume didn't have any blood.
Oh.
The Steel Samurai was not the killer. He was the victim. Don't you see? Jack Hammer was the Steel Samurai.
Order! 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 So, the Steel Samurai in this photograph. You're saying the man in this costume was the victim, Mr. Jack Hammer.
That's what I'm saying, Your Honor. Jack Hammer was present at the action scene run-through that morning. Thus, he obviously knew about Will Powers' foot injury.
But wait! Hadn't Mr. Hammer gone to Studio One already?
That's what everyone thought. But remember what Mrs. Oldbag said in her testimony.
On the day of the murder, I arrived at the guard station at 1 o'clock p.m. Didn't I see poor old Hammer? No, he'd already gone to the studio before I got back to the guard station.
Mr. Jack Hammer left the employee area after lunch. However, no one saw him going to Studio One, nor was there a picture of him. He waited for Mr. Powers to take a nap in his dressing room. Then he snuck into the dressing room and stole the Steel Samurai costume.
But why would the victim do such a thing?
I don't know.
I get it.
Hmm?
I thought that the Steel Samurai was moving strange. So it was a different person inside the suit. Pops!
Huh? Me? What?
Actually, there's one piece of data I saved.
Data?
Yeah, a photo on my digital camera.
Oh boy. What?
Show us, quick!
Sorry. Show us, quick!
No way, man! Not if you're gonna look at me like that!
I just realized that my Phoenix and Miles voices, and even down to the Phoenix and Miles hair, are fucking Sonic and Shadow. Oh my god!
No!
Here. This is it.
Robbie,
hi, Robbie.
You missed our revelation.
Well, looking at this, it's still a little hard to say. I'm afraid that it could have been anyone in that costume. Your opinion, Mr. Wright? Your opinion, Mr. Hedgehog?
I agree, Your Honor. This isn't decisive evidence.
I'm sorry. This doesn't look like it's the proof we need.
Babe.
Yeah?
You know Sonic?
Yeah?
Not Sonic.
Sonic?
Sonic.
Yeah, like from Jeopardy.
Gotta go fast. From Jeopardy?
Yeah. There wasn't there's a Jeopardy episode where they're like what blue haired, wait, let me do my Alex Trebek. What blue haired character? No, that's not Alex. What blue haired character runs goes fast and collects rings?
And then one lady guessed Sanic, and another dude guessed Danky Kang.
Tell me that's a lie. Wait, babe, you did show off your cute new haircut.
Oh, I didn't show off my cute new haircut. The tray gave me. I got a bob.
I'll give it back.
Wait, Phoenix. Mia? What? Look at that photo once more. That's it, Phoenix. That photo is all the evidence you need to win this trial.
What?
Your Honor, may I see that photo once more, please?
Certainly. I don't see why not.
Phoenix, show him. There's a glaring, decisive inconsistency with the facts as we know them in the photo.
Did they...
Is bisexual...
Is bisexual Bob muted?
I think bisexual is muted.
Bisexual very. Add permitted term.
I think bisexual is not a permitted term for some reason. I don't know why. Yeah, our inspiration
Hustle? Was Hustle.
Yeah, our inspiration was Hustle, but then
Is this taped? I didn't see what the prompt was. What did he prompt me with?
What's off about this? Keep looking, it's there.
Is it the tape thing? It's in front of Studio 2.
In front of Studio 2?
Yeah.
Click that.
Take that. Your Honor, look at this.
I see. A gate?
Might I draw your attention to the number on that gate?
The number?
This judge is a fucking idiot.
Ah, yes. Well, it's hard to see. But it looks like a 2.
Clearly not a 1, Your Honor, correct? I believe Mr. Edgeworth sees what I'm getting at. But that's impossible.
What's all this about? Please explain so that I might be shocked along with the rest of the court.
This judge is a fucking... I love him. He's so stupid.
I'll use the studio guide map. The body was found here, in Studio 1. However, what do we see in this photo taken at the time of the murder? It does not say 1 on the gate in the photo. Your Honor, here is the true scene of the crime. It was here.
What does that have to do with the number on the gate in the photograph?
Put 2 and 2 together, buddy. Well, sorry, Your Honor. I guess I hadn't... Oh. Did I point at the wrong spot?
Here, it's Studio 2.
I see. That would explain the 2 on the gate in the photo.
Your Honor, I find it very significant that the murder took place at Studio 2.
Yeah. The trailer is there, the path was blocked, no filming is done there.
As you may recall, there is a trailer in Studio 2. Now, on that day, a meeting was held in that very trailer. There was a break in the meeting corresponding to the time of death. During that break, Mr. Sal Manella and Miss D. Vasquez were outside, eating steak. They were at the scene of the crime.
Aw, oh, man. Seems like Penny's
the
not gonna have
to the
much
the trailer was blocked.
Left.
So we have heard.
The path was blocked at 2:15. In other words, the victim went to Studio 2 before that time.
Yes, I suppose that would be the case.
Remember Mr. Salmonella's testimony? Allow me to remind the court. He said no one in the trailer was guilty, because they could not have gone to Studio One. Yet, in actuality, the reverse was true. Only someone in the trailer could have committed this murder. They were the only ones with access to the scene of the crime, Studio 2.
Order! Order!
The defense makes the following claims. The scene of the crime was Studio 2.
Mm.
The person that the security guard, Miss Oldback, saw was the victim, Mr. Jack Hammer.
Mm.
Mr. Hammer, for some reason, stole a Steel Samurai costume. Then he went to Studio 2.
Why?
This is madness. Jack Hammer is the victim. The victim! Why would he steal a Steel Samurai costume? Are you suggesting that he did so to cover up the details of his own murder?
No, he just wants to be cool.
Yeah, he wanted to go there and... He wanted to go there to Studio 2 and argue with the producer that he should be the one being the Steel Samurai. Clearly.
Well, no, of course not.
Hmm.
Or do you have proof? Give me proof that the victim, Jack Hammer, stole the costume.
Of course we have proof. Yeah, we have proof. For sure, right?
Yeah.
Sleeping pills. Our attorney badge. Can't hurt, right?
I think it actually can.
What do you think? Of course we have proof.
I have proof. You do?
You do, Mr. Wright.
Now that they're so surprised, I'm suddenly much less confident. I think I'm right, though.
Here's my
proof that Jack Hammer stole the costume.
Sleeping pills is the closest, I think.
Sure.
This is it.
An empty medicine bottle?
I found this on the table in the employee area. The same table where Mr. Hammer and Mr. Powers ate. The label reads sleeping pills.
Sleeping pills?
The defendant, Mr. Powers, spent that entire afternoon sleeping. He was drugged by Mr. Hammer.
Objection!
Wait a moment. That bottle does raise some suspicions, yes. But there is no proof that Mr. Hammer used it.
Your Honor, I have an idea.
Fingerprint the bottle!
An idea? Very well, let's hear it.
I want to check this bottle for fingerprints. If my claim is true, Mr. Hammer's fingerprints should be shown up on this bottle.
Hurry!
I suppose you're right. Very well. The court will take possession of the bottle. This court will suspend proceedings on the current trial for today. Cody Hackens' testimony has revealed new possibilities in this case. In fact, things may have happened very differently than we previously thought. The Steel Samurai seen by Miss Oldbag may have been the victim, Jack Hammer. The scene of the crime was not Studio 1, but Studio 2. And those in the trailer did have time to commit murder. Mr. Wright.
Yes, Your Honor?
Your homework is to find the answer to the following question. Why would Mr. Hammer steal the Steel Samurai costume? Also, who killed him, and why?
That's three questions.
Find the answers for me by tomorrow.
That's a lot of homework.
Mr. Edgeworth.
Hmm?
You will need to reconsider your stance in this case. Above all, you will need to reconsider your suspicion of Mr. Will Powers.
As you say, Your Honor.
Could you pass me the chopstick?
This trial will be extended until tomorrow. This is the last extension. Very well. Court is adjourned.
Chung
chung. Chung
chung. Woo. That was a close one. We were saved by a hair, but that's all that counts. I thought seriously about going home about 3 times during that trial. Me too.
Really? You both seem so confident.
Huh. Maybe I should take up a career in acting. Are those rolls done?
Yeah. No. They're on the counter.
I was ready to pronounce you dead about 3 times back there. Me too.
Dead?
Dead? Oh. I mean...
Of course, we're kidding.
Are you sure?
I wasn't kidding.
Now,
Mr. Powers, we have to go make our final investigation. But I promise you, we'll find the true killer by tomorrow's trial.
Right. Thanks.
To be continued.
Oh.
Yeah.
Alright, should we call it for the night? You feeling sleepy?
I just don't want to get wasted.
Yeah, I see. And we've been streaming for an hour and a half.
Yeah.
And my voice is starting to hurt from doing my Sonic the Hedgehog.
Can you talk about the Chaos Emeralds? In both voices.
In which voice?
Just like Chaos Emeralds in Sonic and Chaos Emeralds in Shadow.
Chaos Emeralds! Chaos Emeralds. Found you, faker!
That's SRV2 Dude's raid notification.
Oh,
sound
yeah!
Effect.
You know what you should do?
Yeah.
You should be a voice actor in your job.
Pathetic creatures of the night.
Alright, thank you everyone so much for hanging out with us. I know it was a pretty short stream, but I'm sleepy. I apologize. I'm sleepy, and I'm gonna fall asleep.
Robbie, did your flight get in safe? Seems like it. You're still alive.
Robbie, we love you. Thank you for hopping in. Robbie said he was playing a game with his family before he hopped in.
Oh, I see. Very nice. Quarantining.
Oh, that's my favorite cocktail.
Quarantine in the basement?
No, a quarantini.
Oh, I see.
That's probably what all the white girls are calling their mimosas right now.
Oh my god.
They're like adding a La Croix to a mimosa and being like, I discovered a new drink. No offense. Anyway, see, this is...
I am offended because you said La Croix.
La Croix. Okay, look. When I see La Croix, I say La Croix. Oh, that is acceptable. That is acceptable.
That's a good one.
To call your Mountain Dew pickle martini a quarantini? Perfect. Ink. Wait, Ink, I need to send you Joey's Twitter so you can see their pinned tweet. Do you know what their pinned tweet is?
I think so.
Yeah. I'm sending you Joey's Twitter. Wait, Joey's Twitter is just Joey the Prince, Inc. Look it up. I can't do all the work
on your own time. Yo, this ginger beer was pretty good.
It tasted really good to me, but I was worried for you because it was very nice because it was sweet.
Yeah, it could be more gingery.
Okay, Inc., I'm DMing you anyway because I love you. Please watch this entire video. Do not pause. Do not cross.
Do not go.
Do not kill like $200. Okay. Let's end. Oh, wait. Ink is saying something. Oh.
Limited edition Mountain Dew Doritos, but only in Australia. Crikey.
Crikey! I was in Australia, but it was a while ago. Australia. My favorite thing about Australia was the family I stayed with, every night after dinner they had fresh fruit and custard, because they just sell custard in, like, milk cartons in in Australia.
Interesting.
So you just, it's just thicker than milk.
Ah.
And so you just pour it over your fruit, okay. And it's vanilla and sugary.
The only experience I ever had with custard is that fucking robot from Teletubbies.
No. Well, no. Custard is
I've
like...
I've never had custard before.
Thicca milk.
Yeah.
It's like, have you seen condensed milk?
Yes.
It's that consistency.
Okay.
But where condensed milk is like condensed and like concentrated, custard is like light and airy.
Interesting.
Mm-hmm.
I've only ever seen it coming out of a corrugated plastic pipe.
I hate that
attached to a robot.
His name is Nunu.
Nunu.
Custard is just, you know...
Man, Teletubbies fucked up.
You know when you mix the vanilla pudding
Why
a
they
lot?
Got TVs? Why they got TVs in there? Why has the sun got a face?
Yeah, see?
Okay.
Oh, it's like the filling for an eclair.
Oh.
That's the sort of consistency.
I see.
But gotcha. It's a little looser than that.
I gotcha.
It's loose, so... Ink, please report to Joey. Let him know what you thought about their wisdom. Okay, I'm fading fast.
Okay.
Time to end stream.
Okay. I'm ending stream.
Good night.
Bye-bye.